start with University Rugby and France against England.
There's a rich sort of history of competition between the two nations.
It's always special against England. They're proud, they're aggressive, and we always concentrate our efforts to beat them.
It's a great game to play in, awesome atmosphere, some really aggressive tackling flying in from both teams.
It's not like we don't like them, but they don't like us, so we're not going to like them. For sure, it's going to be a great rugby match.
It will be tough, it'll be a physical match, and I'm really looking forward to it.
These young players are French rugby's greatest hopes. Maybe the next Dussatoir, Ibanez, Palouse or Betson. They all experienced French universities at the beginning of their careers. They all have the common experience of juggling high-level rugby and university studies. I'm Paul Jedrasiak, I'm 20 years of age, I'm a lock with Clément Auvergne, and I'm studying English. Only 20 and already playing with one of the best clubs in the top 14. But what about playing against England? Well, so far, there's not that much tension, but I'm sure it'll rise gradually tomorrow. It's going to be a good game. It's exciting to play matches like this with a little bit at stake. We might be able to say we've beaten England. That would be great. To wear the French shirt, you know, it's everything. You feel so much pride. We're playing with the very best French players here, so it really means something. I don't anticipate the future, by the way. I just do the best I can to fulfill my dreams and to become a professional rugby player. Okay, let's start with the landing and returns. Everybody set? My name is Charles Brousse. I'm a centre for France universities. I play for Bordeaux in the top 14. I study sports science. Charles is also the captain of France U. For him, beating England is, above all, a question of pride. It's historic, really. It's handed down from generation to generation. We don't really like their behavior, and they don't really like ours. It's a little battle of pride, yes. All the more so because it's been 2 years since they've beaten us. So I know they've come here to beat us. We also have the pressure of the result, even though the coaches don't put it on us. But we are preparing calmly. We feel good. It's nice to live all together. We're students, don't forget, so we're a bit more relaxed. There's less pressure than in our clubs. We're here to enjoy it. Time for the French students to take it easy in their hotel. So what's the recipe to beat England? Essentially, it's rice, mashed potatoes, starch. Pastas, we always get to eat the same things, really. But is there some forbidden food? Well, no, nothing is directly prohibited, but the coaches choose the menus. D-Day. It's now the English students' turn to train on the pitch, where they'll play against France tonight.
I'm George Messam. I study at Loughborough University. I'm 22 years old, and I study international relations and politics. Playing out in France is a huge honour. The French are quite a passionate sort of rugby playing nation. So it's a lovely facility as well. So I'm looking forward to getting out and hopefully having a good win. There's some quite sort of feisty encounters when we play tonight. But again, you know, in the spirit of rugby, after the game, we'll have a good drink together. I think I'm going to finish my studies and hopefully within sort of the next 5 years, hopefully play a bit of professional rugby as well. And you know, it's a very short career, so you just got to make the most of it while you can and, while I'm still fit and able, I guess. So, just hopefully sort of playing professional rugby in the next 5 years.
I'm from Loughborough University, 23 years old, and I play fly half, number 10.
Who knows? He may be the next Johnny Wilkinson. He certainly loves to play for his country.
No, I'm really looking forward to tonight, really special atmosphere. The crowd definitely gets behind the players, and I know how special it is for the boys to put on the England shirt and sing the national anthem. in front of all their families and friends. So yeah, it's going to be awesome. Top 14, maybe one day, I don't know. For now, I'm finishing my final year of university, and hopefully next year, I'm going to be starting my career in the professional game.
In the last 10 confrontations, England have beaten France only three times. Good motivation for the English.
The feeling is a bit of excitement, a bit of anxiety, but ready to go, ready to hit the first tackle and kick the first kick at goal. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
When they run onto the pitch tonight, wearing the English shirt and the red rose on it, nothing will be better than this.
Number 10, Sam Catchlock-Brooks.
There's a real tradition in the shirt. You know, you only get a couple of times to wear it, so you just have to add your part of it and, you know, pass it on to the next person and, you know, do the shirt justice. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to tonight, and hopefully we can do ourselves proud and, yeah, put pride in the jersey.
It's going to be played at a really fast pace. The guys will try combinations. OK, it's going to be very important to watch out, run onto the through ball. We have to attack them in the right spaces. A few minutes before kickoff, time for some concentration.
We'll get ourselves mentally prepared, and it'll be quite an intense first 20 minutes, and we're looking forward to the challenge that's going to be ahead.
The final training session. Tonight, the teams will play in front of 4,000 spectators. England created this sport, it's in their genes, you know, whereas we've learnt it, but we've learnt a lot, and we're as good as them now. It's going to be serious, full, frank, play within the rules, but also forcefully friendly.
Memory of playing for students is every bit as good as playing for England, because the camaraderie and the type of game we played was fantastic. I remember now it's 25 years ago that I played, but still my memory of the student games is crystal clear. We played at Pouc in Paris. Normally I can't remember what I did last week, but that match I can remember everything that happened before the game, after the game, the excitement. So I said to them, make it a good memory, because it's nice to have a good memory 25 years later.
A strong 10 minutes, a penalty from Sam Katz, and the England students put the first points on the board. Even though they make mistakes, we're always late compared to them. We need to fix that, use our power several times, then go wide, OK? The French begin to gain the upper hand, forcing mistakes. 19 minutes gone, and here comes the first try for France. The conversion would follow it, and then it would be a struggle for supremacy, with numerous lineouts and some very strong driving play from both sides. The English students coming under pressure again. Another try for France. The conversion will be kicked, and the halftime score, 19-3. If you see somebody's protecting the ruck, don't hesitate to get involved. If there's someone leaving a foot in there, move in. We'll push them back. Don't play the ball, push them back. That's going to slow the ball down. Come on, let's go. In the second half, England continue to soak up French pressure. Tom Crozier would score a try for them on 58 minutes. Katz would add the conversion to make it 22-10 and give them a glimmer of hope. But England continue to chase the game and can't make ground in face of strong French defence and the speed of their attack. And the French would finish strongly. Two tries in the dying moments from their captain Brousse on the 78th and the 80th minute. Both tries would be converted, and the final score would be France 39, England 10. It was a really tough game. It was harsh, but we worked hard, and it was great to win a crunch match like this. If somebody had told us before the game that would be the score, we'd have taken it right away. We played a great game tonight.
a good memory, but it was good. Big crowd, unbelievable atmosphere. Some of the players on the England side hadn't experienced that before. It's very off-putting if that's the case. I think next time we'll be more prepared.
So the French challenge again too strong for the disappointed English, but as Sam says, there's always next time.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,